Hello and welcome to the fourth tutorial in the series on the interactive costing tool. Today we'll be looking at industry submitting a site costing after it's been validated by the lead LCRN. By now, as an industry contact, you should be in receipt of an email from your lead network explaining a validation has been carried out. And when you go back into your study submission page, you'll be able to spot the study, and when you scroll down, you'll see that that study has had its study resource review completed. You can now access that study again. If you were to go in the same way as you would have done before, you'll see that it's no longer present at the bottom of the page here and states that you can review the results and continue to update the ICT details of the study either through the interactive costing tool menu or following the link here. We're actually going to go in via the industry costing tool menu, which is the little tick box. And there you will see the project at the top and an action on the right that says view details. Let's go to the view details. So once this has come back from the lead network, there may be a number of comments that are open on it, which you'll be able to see in this box here. It'll tell you if there are any changes or updates that have been made by the lead network during the validation process. So the first thing to do will be to click on that and then to look for items that have an orange flag similar to this. You'll see, having picked up from the previous page, that you will need to be looking for six items. You'll see there is one here that states the visit was added as a telephone follow-up call because it's present within page 11 of the protocol, and you would, for example, accept that. Or alternatively, if you disputed the statement made by the LCRN, you would just close the item and then contact the LCRN to ask them whether the addition of it was appropriate or not. That's all standard part of the normal validation process carried out by the lead networks. Rather than going through all the six changes that are within this, I'm actually, for the purposes of this tutorial, going to accept all of the changes that have been made so that we can move on to the next part. Once done, we go back to the individual study ICT menu. You see this has now gone down to zero. It's also worth saying at this point, if you want to double check those ones that you've accepted, you can click on this button and it will reflag them in green to show their accepted changes. So once it's been done, you can return to this page. You will see that if your sites have been listed within CPMS already, they will be ported into the bottom of this table under study organisations. If you do not have a site listed within the CPMS study record, it will not appear here. And it's not possible to actually add sites in through ICT. They all get added within the study record. So if you do not have sites in the study record, you will not be able to proceed to the next stage. As we have sites here, we'll be able to proceed to the next stage, which very simply will be to view the individual costs at the given site. And if we go back to the main menu just to start here, you'll be able to see that it looks very, very similar to what you had at study level, mainly because it's copied every single item that was reviewed at validation into the given site. Differences in this page are that it now includes the indirect capacity building and MFF costs for the relevant visits, and also within the cost breakdown for each individual activity that is carried out, it also includes the indirect cost, capacity building and MFF values. We return to the main screen here, you'll see there's now a separate arm that's been set up that's titled a Setup and Closedown. This is simply to pick out the individual localized changes in relation to Setup and Closedown, not necessarily impacting directly on per patient care. It's exactly the same as the original worksheet that was in with the Excel template. Within here, very simply, there are a selection of departments which have associated activity with them. For example, if somebody was to pick cardiovascular as a service department being used in the study, you would find that under the activities there is only one setup cost. You can choose this as an example, and it shows the standard £250, which is in the industry costing template as a departmental setup fee. Other departments, such as radiology, have larger numbers of setup fees dependent on whether things like CRE assessments, MPE assessments, or phantom scanning is required on a given study. All of these can be added at this point if they're requested within the setup or close down costs for your trial. for the sake of completion, what we're going to do is add in a general R&D fee, which again is at the standard setup costs for the given study. Because this page can be completed either by the industry contact or by the NHS site, you will always be required to add a comment to explain the changes that have been made. And there you can see it has been added with a grey flag that shows that you've added it and you will wait for the site to accept or further action that change. At this point, with an R&D fee completed, and if you are happy with the individual visits that occur at the individual time points, you'll be able to submit this to the site. It should be remembered at this point that the interactive costing tool is not a communication tool. It's based as a tool for calculating cost. So on that basis, you will still need to email the given site and your contact at that given site to let them know costing tool has been assigned to them. And the second thing you will need to do is to contact your national portfolio manager, who is the same person you would normally contact to add study contacts to a study, to get the individual who will be performing the costing at site added as a study contact or site representative. When that has been done, the individual site will be able to see exactly what you are seeing on the screen. It is hoped that any further negotiation beyond that will be carried out either by telephone or via email. As ICT within CPMS is a live system, it is entirely possible to be able to open a given main page or setup and close down page at the same time as somebody at the site is doing so, so that you can be discussed in a live environment online. And that concludes the fourth instalment of this ICT tutorial. Thank you.